four question answers. So the sectors, yes.
No problem.
Now that you can also change your seat. So many number of vacant benches are there. So the sectors, last one, the sectors classified into as a public and a private sector, it is based upon a which category? First, employment conditions. Second, the nature of economic activities. Third, ownership of enterprises. Fourth, number of workers employed in the enterprise. Akshit said properly. Yes. Answer. Straightforward MCQ question. The sectors are classified into as a public and a private sector on the basis of employment conditions, nature of economic activities, ownership of enterprises, fourth, number of workers employed in the enterprise, third, ownership. On the basis of a control management ownership, sectors can classify into public and private sector. Come forward, first bench. Second question, production of a commodity mostly through the natural processes is an, yes, Vivan Kumar, production of a goods mostly through the natural processes is an activity of dash sector. First, tertiary sector. Second, information technology. Third, primary. Fourth, secondary. Production of Grover, any problem? The production of commodities mostly through the natural processes is an activity in dash sector. Give two examples. Another good answer. Very good. Primary sector. Primary sector. Primary sector. Any examples? Vivan Kumar, examples? Coal? Coal producing? People are producing the coal. How is this possible? Agriculture. Fishing, mining. Third, you sit down. GDP is the total value of dash produced during a particular year. GDP is the total value of dash produced during a particular year. First, all final goods and services. Second, all goods and services. Third, all intermediate goods and services. Fourth, all intermediate and final goods and services. GDP is the total value of some value of dash produced during a particular year.
All final goods and services.
Final goods and services. And what's what it means, the intermediate goods, which has marked here, intermediate goods. Yes, the other one. Intermediate goods means? You don't know. Yes, you want to. Second bench. What it means, the intermediate goods? She said, GDP is the sum value of the final goods. But what it means, the intermediate goods? Intermediate. Who will answer? Yes. Sorry. Further production for processing. They are can't be used as a directly consumed by the consumers. It can be used for the further processing. Clear, Akshit? So these are the intermediate goods. Answer is the final goods and services. Third, fourth, in terms of GDP, the share of a tertiary sector in 2013-14 is between dash percent. It is based upon a figure given on page number The figure based upon a 2013 and 14, the share of a tertiary sector, what was it? Options are, yes, Akshit. Options are 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 50 to 60, and 60 to 70. The share of a tertiary sector in GDP, as per the according the data of 2013 and 14, it was dash percentage. Very good answer. Yes, 50. Very good. 50 to 60. Question number 6. Do you think the classification of economic activities into the primary, secondary, and tertiary is useful? Is it useful or not? The categorization of a sector is based upon a production, primary, secondary, and tertiary. They are useful or not? If useful, how? If no, then no problem. Now, Akshit, your answer. Are you agree with this? Categorization of a sector is based upon a production, primary, secondary, and tertiary. They are useful in Indian economy or not? Haan ji? Useful hai. Kaise? Kaise? Yes, Akshit? Aapne yes kaha na, to soch ke kaha hoga aapne? Vaise keh diya? Yes, you? What's your name? Pakkad. Yes. How is it useful for us? Categorization of a primary, secondary, and tertiary. Said properly. Haan ji? Read karke. What is this? What is this? What's the use of this in classroom? कोई जरूरत है इसकी? सॉरी, एनसीईआरटी मैंने मांगी आपसे. मैं आंसर बोल रहा, क्वेश्चन बोल रहा हूं आपको. बंद कर दीजिए इसे. थैंक यू. और इसे बैग में रख दो, साइड में रख दो. यस, आंसर आंसर. यस प्रिंसी, आंसर. It tells about the various activities which categorize under the different sectors and their contribution in economy through the dash. Through dash. Contribution in economy through dash. No. Sit down. Through dash. The contribution of these three sectors in economy through dash.
Sir, may I speak now?
Commodities which are produced by the people. Commodities produced by the people. Commodities produced by the people. Which are includes under the GDP of the country or national income. Question number 7, sit down. For each of the sectors that we came across in this chapter, why should one focus on employment and GDP, not the other aspects? Remember, last chapter, development. You read the two of the classifications of the world economies. One, as per the, according to the World Bank, which categorized the world economies on the basis of economic indicators. Yes, Lakshmago, aapne padha tha? Nahi padha? First chapter. You appeared for the PT1. Yes, Ayan. One of the classifications given in a previous chapter as a World Bank, which use as in economic indicators, according to which countries divided into three categories, developed, developing, and underdeveloped. But according to the World Bank, India lies in the underdeveloped economies because of their low per capita income. But as per the report of HDI stands for Aryan, yes, HDI stands for, this was the question asked in a PT1, Human Development Index. It used the criterias, Aryan, yes. HDI used the criterias as, which of the criterias use? GDP, employment, okay. Income of GDP, employment, income, okay. Any other? एनी अदर वेट नहीं, जहां तक आप एम्प्लॉयमेंट की बात करते हो, जीडीपी की बात करते हो, और तीसरा क्या आप आपने कहा इनकम, ऑल दीज आर द इकोनॉमिक इंडिकेटर्स, सोशल इंडिकेटर्स। विच आर द सोशल इंडिकेटर्स यूज इन दिस HDI और UNDP रिपोर्ट, यूनाइटेड नेशंस डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम? विल आंसर सोशल इंडिकेटर्स, यस, हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन सोशल इंडिकेटर्स। When we use these two criteria, economic and social indicators, India lies in a developing economies because the level of literacy in our country, total number of enrollments in our country, infant mortality rate in our country, life expectancy in our country is a better comparatively with the other countries, like as a Pakistan. Pakistan lies under the underdeveloped economies. So we can't use as a one criteria economic for a categorization of world economies. Now the question is, for each of the sectors that we came across in this chapter, why should one focus on employment and GDP only? Because different activities associated with the growth and development of economy are concentrated towards the GDP. If the GDP of a country is more than the 15%, such countries are the developed economies of the world. Developed economies. Development kya hai? In that country where the poverty not exists. Poverty. It has not exist in a developed countries. Government capable to feed the population if the population not doing a work. If the population is not productive for the country, productive when they are not producing goods and services, government is capable to feed them. Clear? Yeah. किसे टू पॉपुलेशन, अगर कोई काम नहीं करता उन गवर्नमेंट्स के पास इतने रिसोर्सेज है दे कैन फीड देम, बट इन इंडिया देर आर 27% पीपल आर अंडर पॉवर्टी, आर गवर्नमेंट नॉट केपेबल टू फीड देम एज फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट? क्लियर? सो कुड देयर बी द अदर इश्यूज विच शुड बी एग्जामिन? यस, सोशल इंडिकेटर्स, हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन, इट शुड बी ऑल्सो डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग एज अ इकोनॉमिक एंड सोशल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ कंट्री. Making a long list of all kinds of work that you find adults around you doing for a living in, what way can you classify them and explain your choice? Number of works which are generally done by the people in our surroundings, in cities, we can categorize on a which categories? Three of the classifications we discussed in a chapter. Which classification is suitable for a explaining that the number of activities which are generally occurred in cities? Wait, Ranveer, you are the Ranveer, then answer it. Are you living in a city since last 15-16 years? It means you are more familiar with them. The number of activities which are generally done by the people for the earning of their livelihoods. Yes, Ranveer Singh. Which classification of a sector is suitable for a Jalandhar? Ranveer, say yes or no. Secondary or tertiary? Fir primary kahan gaya? Which classification is suitable? Yes, you. On the basis of nature. Okay. Anybody else? Your answer. Second girl. Your answer. Secondary tertiary. Grover. Same. And the other one. Which classification from this chapter is suitable to categorize the type of activities done by the people in cities for the earning of their livelihoods? नेचर कैटेगराइज करो, कौन सी है? प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी, टर्शरी? योर आंसर सेम. यस, यू कक्कड़, व्हाट इज योर आंसर? सेकेंडरी और टर्शरी? एनीबडी एल्स? नोबडी. सेकेंड क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड अपॉन वर्किंग कंडीशंस, ऑर्गेनाइज एंड अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर. ऑर्गेनाइज एंड अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर. आप नेचर की बात करते हो, प्राइमरी सेक्टर फिशिंग एग्रीकल्चर माइनिंग इज पॉसिबल इन सिटीज? दे आर पॉसिबल इन सिटीज. मैंने आपकी एडजॉइनिंग आपके सराउंडिंग एरियाज की बात की, जलंधर की एग्जांपल दी. जलंधर में कौन से सेक्टर्स की क्लासिफिकेशन सुटेबल रहेगी? प्राइमरी आता है जलंधर में? आता है नहीं आता है? सही यस और नो. रणवीर को तो आ नहीं रहा, यस नो बोलना. सो सेकंड क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड अपॉन वर्किंग कंडीशंस, बेस्ड ऑन वर्किंग कंडीशंस आर सुटेबल फॉर अ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सेक्टर्स, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सेक्टर्स एंड एक्सप्लेन देम, एक्सप्लेन बोथ ऑफ देम विद एग्जांपल. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ द सेकेंडरी हो सकता है, टर्शियरी होता है. व्हाट अबाउट द प्राइमरी? उन्होंने पूछा है विच क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सेक्टर्स कैन यूज इन योर सराउंडिंग्स. आप सिटी में रह रहे हैं, सिटी में प्राइमरी पॉसिबल है, एग्रीकल्चर पॉसिबल है, तो दैट्स वेरी गुड, वेल एंड गुड. अगर आप कहते हैं तो, अगर आप कहते हैं किचन गार्डनिंग एट योर होम इज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ प्राइमरी, यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग समथिंग फॉर द इकोनॉमी, दैट्स वेरी गुड. बट सच मटीरियल्स यू प्रोड्यूस फॉर योर फैमिली ओनली, किचन गार्डनिंग. So working conditions, organized and unorganized, with their meaning and example. That's it. Next, how is tertiary sector different from the other sectors? Illustrate with a example. Who will answer this? Tertiary sector. Tertiary sector. How is it different from the other sectors? Yes, Dipanshu. Tertiary sector. How is it different from the other sectors? There is a basic difference between the primary, secondary and tertiary. Primary, secondary in one side, tertiary in a second, other side. What is the basic difference between them? Yes, Dipanshu? Nahi aata. Yes, Kapil? Manufacture karte. Thoda aur easy karo. Unhe samajh nahi aaya. Yes, you. सही हो आप, यू आर करेक्ट. योर आंसर सेम, व्हाट सेम एज गुलीन जिया धवन, दैट्स इट. देन व्हाट इज योर आइडेंटिटी? वी आर हैविंग द यूनिक आइडेंटिटी, प्रूव इट. आप अपनी एक्सप्लेनेशन दो. Tertiary sector only produces services and a primary and secondary produce the goods. ये आपकी uniqueness है. Paper में ये मत लिखे ना, same as G.R. Dhawan. Give us a 5 marks. Same as लिखते रहना. So very good. So example is the kind of the services which are required for the growth in a primary and a secondary sector, means of transport, communication, banking, insurance. How they correlate with the agriculture and manufacturing sector. Manufacturing sector. What do you understand by the disguised unemployed? Disguised unemployed, when more people are employed as compared to the demand, is a disguised unemployment. Distinguish between as open unemployment and disguised unemployment. It's an easy question, Madhu. Open unemployment. What it means unemployment? Unemployment. Berezgari kya hoti hai? जिनके पास जॉब नहीं होती है वो अनएम्प्लॉयड हैं. इजी. कितने मार्क्स एक्सपेक्ट करते हो? 2 मार्क्स में अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट एक्सप्लेन करने को आ जाए. जिनके पास जॉब नहीं होती है, जिनका इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस अच्छा नहीं होता है, पुअर होता है, वो तो पॉवर्टी है. दे आर लिविंग द अंडर पॉवर्टी लाइन. दे आर नोन नॉट नोन एज द अनएम्प्लॉयड. दे आर नॉट नोन एज द अनएम्प्लॉयड. एक फार्मर है, उसके पास जॉब है, उसके पास लैंड है, इट इज अ सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयड, बट हैविंग द लेस मनी यू विल कैटेगराइज हिम एज द अनएम्प्लॉयड. आप कह रहे हैं देयर इज अ वेंडर, वेजिटेबल वेंडर सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयड, बट द पर्सन इज इकोनॉमिकली पुअर, बट यू विल कॉल द सच पीपल एज अनएम्प्लॉयड. आप यही कह रहे हैं जिसका इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस लो है वो अनएम्प्लॉयड है. हाँ जी, जिसके पास सोर्स ऑफ इनकम नहीं होता, कहोगे कैसे, एक्सप्लेन कैसे करो? सही हो आप. व्हेन अ पर्सन इज रेडी टू वर्क एज प्रेजेंट वेज रेट, जो सैलरी सेट है मार्केट के अंदर, सोसाइटी के अंदर, इकोनॉमी के अंदर, when a person is ready to work as present wages, present income, but unable to find the jobs as an unemployment. This is the unemployment. काम करने को वो रेडी है पर उसे काम नहीं मिल रहा है, ठीक है ना, यहाँ क्वालिफाई नहीं काम है नहीं, ठीक है, एबल इट इज रेडी टू वर्क एज प्रेजेंट वेजेस, काम चाहता है पर काम नहीं मिल रहा, दिस इज दैट पर्सन इज अनएम्प्लॉयड. अगर आप कहोगे दैट पर्सन इज अ वेल क्वालिफाइड नॉट हैविंग द एडिक्वेट जॉब्स एज पर देयर नेसेसिटीज, इट विल बी एज एजुकेशनल अनएम्प्लॉयड और टेक्निकल अनएम्प्लॉयड. टेक्निकल अनएम्प्लॉयड एक इंजीनियर है, फाइव ईयर्स की डिग्री है उसके पास, पर डिग्री के आफ्टरवर्ड्स द पर्सन हैज अर्निंग द 5000 टू 10000 रुपीस, देन द पर्सन इज नॉट एग्री टू वर्क, दिस इज द एज अ टेक्निकल अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. टेक्निकल वो प्रेजेंट जो काम है वो उसके एडिक्वेट उसके अकॉर्डिंगली नहीं है. सो द ओपन अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इज अ सिचुएशन इन व्हिच अ पर्सन इज रेडी टू वर्क बट अनेबल टू फाइंड द जॉब्स इज अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. डिसगाइज्ड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इज अ स्टेट इज इट इज अ सिचुएशन इन व्हिच पीपल आर एम्प्लॉयड बट their exclusion and inclusion do not affect dash, do not affect dash. Aryan, very good. Removal or inclusion of a workforce in a working site do not influence the production. And which of the sectors these are exist? Open unemployment exists in all the sectors, all sectors, primary, secondary, tertiary, where disguised unemployment only exists in a primary sector, primary sector. Especially in agriculture only. Mining may be nahi hai. Agar mining mein number of a workforce you will include, increase, then the more production will occur. Production badhegi, number of hours fixed hai, 8 hours hai. Jo kaam pehle 2 log karte the, aaj 10 log kar rahe hain mines ke andar. Production simultaneously badhegi. Theek hai na? More production in a, through the fishing, production badhegi. But in agriculture is only a sector where production not increase with inclusion of a laborers. Because production based on a land resource. So service sector, tertiary sector, sorry, 12th question, tertiary sector is not playing any significant role in the development of Indian economy. Do you agree? Are you agree, Akshay? No? Pay attention. Tertiary sector is not playing any significant role in the development of Indian economy. Do you agree with this? No? It played an important role in development of Indian economy. Give reasons. You are correct. Yes, tertiary sector played a very important role in a development of economy. How? Justify the statement. Very good answer. Very good. Thank you, Akshay. Increase in job opportunities. Increase in job opportunities. Second, increase in share in GDP of country. Increase in share of GDP of our country. Third, it helps to ensure production in primary and secondary. With the growth of our tertiary sector, it helps to produce more number of goods in primary and secondary. Clear, Dipanshu? Repeat that. More goods, very good. Tertiary sector produces goods. Okay, second, tertiary sector produces goods as per according to the Dipanshu. Sure, are you sure? Second one, Dipanshu, answer do nahi to mere saath.